So consider again our original difference and difference regression specification without the fixed effects. So R's default formula for the standard errors of the coefficients is only correct if the error terms are all identically and independently distributed from each other. Now, often this assumption is violated. So the plot here on the right shows the residuals from our regression for three different DMAs indicated by color. So we have basically, I've shown for all the three DMAs the residuals for every day. And the green residuals are all for this market area 503, the red for market area 501, and the blue for market area 504. And you clearly see that the residuals seem to be related to the market area. So for all the red residuals, which are from market area, they're all strictly above zero, all around this 2000. All of the green market area are below zero. So these are residuals which are not independently distributed from each other. So one residual from market area 501 is strongly correlated with the other residuals from market area 501. So the standard errors that would come out of running this linear equation using LM then are also wrong, because they assume that these U's are basically independent and so all should be randomly fluctuating around the zero, and there should be no systematic relationship with the DMA to be seen in the residuals. Okay. One remedy, so to get kind of correct standard error, is so called is to compute so-called cluster robust standard errors. These standard errors are also correct if we allow for the error terms for the same DMA to be strongly correlated with each other, what we see here in this data set. The FELM command in the LFE packages allows a simple way to compute such cluster robust standard errors. So you basically, here this is a long formula, there are a lot of vertical bars, and here this would be for fixed effects, this would be for instruments, which will be discussed later, and then the last way that are variables for which we want to cluster the standard error. And if I type here DMA, then the standard errors will be clustered for DMA, so we allow for arbitrary correlation within each region. And here are the estimation results. The first estimation is kind of this regression estimated without cluster robust standard errors. The second is with cluster robust standard errors, so clustered on the DMAs. And interesting, what we see is that if we have clustered standard errors, the standard error for our treatment effect is even smaller. So this can happen, even though it's called close cluster robust, and what I actually think is more robust means larger standard errors. They can even be smaller here. But for example, the standard error for our treat variable, which is actually just a control variable here, that would be larger. But for the variable of interest, actually using cluster robust standard errors makes the standard error smaller. And typically in empirical papers, you very often find such cluster robust standard errors. And then it's typically written in the regression table what is the variable we have clustered on. And you could also use these cluster robust standard errors together with fixed effects. So we can have DMA fixed effects and allow the standard errors still to be clustered on the DMA. Here, the first is the fixed effects regression, fixed effects for DMA on days without clustered standard errors. And here's the one with clustered standard errors, clustered on DMA. But you see that here, the standard errors don't change much. So combining clustered standard errors and fixed effects typically doesn't have such a big impact. And so here, clustering the standard errors makes the standard errors a little bit larger than if you have the fixed effects regression without the clustered standard errors. But it's not a big difference in the standard errors. While in the original regression where we didn't add the DMA fixed effects, clustering the standard errors on DMA had a big impact on the estimated standard error. So there are several econometric research papers who studies what is the best formula for cluster standard errors, in which situation they work good, in which situations they don't work so well. And there also come out newer R packages to try to incorporate these new ideas. For example, there's a package called Glub Sandwich, which has very modern methods of cluster standard errors. But I don't want to dig deeper into this in this course. I just wanted to tell you they are often used, such cluster standard errors, and there are R packages that you can use to compute yourself such cluster robust standard errors.